TFNN. Headline news update. Here's Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We have the Dow Industrials down 40. You get the NASDAQ up 60. S&Ps are up 4.5. Gold contract down $7.10 at $12.71. We have silver down 3 cents, $16.29. Light sweet crude up $1.16, $66.22. Notes and bonds. 10-year note down 7 ticks, 119.20. 30-year bond off 30, 143.16. And King Dollar. King Dollar down 14 ticks, trading at 94.715. The euro is at 115.88. to one U.S. dollar. Yen is at 110.39 to one U.S. dollar. We get over and we take a look. Let's go into the NDX 100 as well as the NASDAQ composite. Bottom line, both at highs. The NDX 100, 72.85. That just took out the high that was generated last week at 72.91. Composite actually took out a high yesterday, went to a higher high today. Composite is at 77.84. That took out the high last week of 77.68. S&P, different ball game. Dow, different ball game. S&P out here, and it's going to be all the tariff issues. Bottom line, S&P up 7 points. Still having a tough time getting anywhere near this 2,800 level. That was just the last swing high. That was on March 16th. Dow Industrials, same type of setup inside the Dow Industrials, and these are going to be large multinationals, folks. Bottom line is that they will get hurt with the Taft issues. Dow Industrials, bottom line is down $43. That baby wants lower price. Small caps, a different ballgame. Small caps, they're all-time highs. Small caps out here, we got price spread, and it's volume, and it's pushing away from the price also. So I suspect when we take a look at these markets, it's going to be the small caps that basically top out last. Gold contract, that's been in an ABC structure on the way down. We got to 1270 today. 1267 is the number on that. The A to B equals C to D. So you get $3 more to do a one-to-one ABC structure on the way down. If we do go over to King Dollar and take a look at King Dollar, it's going to get intriguing here. King Dollar almost looks like it may have topped out. It's going to be intriguing if that's what it is, because if that's what you have on a continuous contract, what you have done is that you went into the October 2017 swing points, and that was 95.070, and that's where you gave it up. So bottom line is that we'll see how that shakes out in the next few days. Stay right there, folks. Next 60 minutes of trading coming up, last 60 minutes of the day, and then we have some numbers coming after the close. To recap out here, we had the Dow Industrials down 38, NASDAQ up 60, S&P's up 5.5. We are coming right back.